This lecture will be a continuation of the previous lecture of joint diseases. During this lecture, we will discuss bone diseases. We subdivide bone diseases into acquired diseases of the bone, which are the osteoporosis, لهشاشة العظام, and osteomalacia. Second, osteomyelitis, which is inflammation of the bone and infections of the bone. And third is bone tumors. We will cover some of the acquired bone conditions and osteomyelitis. So we will start with osteoporosis. Osteoporosis, أو مرض هشاشة العظام, is an acquired condition. Means that it's not familial or inherited. It is related to the environmental factors and mostly to aging process. The definition of osteoporosis is reduced bone mass, كثافة العظم بتقل أو كتلة العظم بتقل, leading to bone fragility and susceptibility to fractures. So the bone is fragile and hash نسميه في العامية, وبالتالي هو عرضه أكثر للكسور. When does osteoporosis occurs? It occurs when the dynamic balance between the bone formation and the bone resorption tilts toward the bone resorption. يعني بيزيد البون resorption على البون formation. احنا بنعرف انه البون formation is performed by osteoblasts, خلايا تكوين العظم, والبون resorption is performed by osteoclasts, اللي هي الخلايا اللي بتدمر او بتاكل العظم. So there should be a balance between them, بحيث انه البون فورميشن والريزوربشن ما واحد منهم يطغى على الثاني. بالاوستيوبوروسيس اللي بيصير انه more resorption of bone takes place. And we have a primary osteoporosis and secondary forms of osteoporosis. البرايمري بالعاده ما في سبب واضح, هو related للعمر, للايجنج process. والسكندري فورمز بيكون في underlying cause for the osteoporosis, وبالعادة هدول بصيروا على younger age group. So here in this table you can see that we have two forms of osteoporosis, the primary osteoporosis and the secondary osteoporosis. Look at the long list of causes for secondary osteoporosis and just two causes for primary osteoporosis, which are the senile, that is related to aging, and the postmenopausal state in females after the age of menopause or after the age of 50 usually. The secondary causes are so many. We have endocrine disorders, gastrointestinal disorders, drugs, and other miscellaneous conditions. From the endocrine disorders like hyperparathyroidism, زيادة في إفراز هرمون الغدة جارات الدرقية, hypo or hyperthyroidism, hypogonadism, some pituitary tumors that may lead to the formation of hyperparathyroidism or hyperthyroidism, type 1 diabetes, Addison disease, tumors of the bone, multiple myeloma, which is another tumor of the bone, gastrointestinal disorders like malnutrition and malabsorption, hepatic insufficiency, vitamin C and vitamin D deficiency, all of these can lead to osteoporosis. By the way, vitamin D deficiency can cause another disease called osteomalacia or rickets in children, which are different stories, and we will talk about them later. Some of the drugs like anticoagulants, chemotherapeutic drugs, corticosteroids, very important cause for the long-term use of corticosteroids can result in osteoporosis, anticonvulsants, and alcohol. That's why patients اللي بياخدوا corticosteroids for a long period of time لازم ياخدوا معاهم vitamin D and calcium supplements. In addition to other diseases like immobilization, pulmonary conditions, and etc. What you have to know here that if we have a secondary cause, we have to treat the secondary cause, but primary osteoporosis cannot be treated because it is as a result of the aging process. So again, so primary osteoporosis is the most common form. It's more common than secondary osteoporosis, and it may be associated with aging, which we call it senile osteoporosis, إلها علاقة بالتقدم في العمر, or postmenopausal state. In females, we call it postmenopausal osteoporosis. What happens in the postmenopausal group is the drop in estrogen levels. Estrogen levels become very low, and this will exacerbate the bone loss that occurs with aging. So females are placed on the double the risk of osteoporosis due to the aging, especially in older females. They are prone to the effects of senile osteoporosis and postmenopausal osteoporosis when compared to males. So females are affected by osteoporosis much more common due to the dual effect of the aging and the postmenopausal state due to the drop in estrogen. So here in this diagrammatic presentation, we can see the dual effect of aging and menopause on osteoporosis. Both of them can lead to osteoporosis. What's the mechanism? Before we know the mechanism, we have to know what is the peak bone mass. The peak bone mass اللي هي أكثر كتلة عظم ممكن يحصلها الإنسان. وهي تعتمد على عدة factors. تعتمد على الجيناتيك فاكتورز بدرجة أولى. تعتمد على النوتريشنال ستيت بدرجة ثانية. وبتعتمد على الفيزيكال اكتيفيتي اند اكسرسايز بدرجة ثالثة. فكل ما كانت البيك بون ماس أعلى بسبب good nutrition, بسبب good physical activity, plus the presence of genetic factors, this will delay أو يأخر العمر اللي بيصير عليه الأوستيوبروسس. فكل ما بتبني كثافة عظم أو كتلة عظم أحسن during the young years of life, كل ما بتأخر حدوث الأوستيوبروسس. اللي بيصير في الأيجينج واللي بيؤدي للأوستيوبروسس هو decrease in the replicative activity of the osteoprogenitor cells اللي هي الخلايا اللي بتعطي الأوستيوبلاستس و decrease في synthetic activity. حتى الأوستيوبلاست بتهرم أو بتسيبها شيخوخة وبالتالي بتقل synthetic ability تبعيتها وقدرتها على تصنيع العظم وبرضو decrease في biologic activity of the growth factors اللي هي ضرورية لنمو العظم وبرضه بيصير في الايجنج reduced physical activity immobilization bedridden patients هذول كلياتهم بيخلوا البيشنت يدخل في osteoporosis وبيؤدوا الى decreased bone mass. في المينوبوز اللي بيصير هو decreased serum estrogen وthis will increase the levels of interleukin 1 interleukin 6 وtumor necrosis factor levels هذول كلياتهم بيؤدوا لزياده بالosteoclastic activity. فإحنا أي إشي بيقلل الأوستيوبلاستيك أكتيفيتي وتكوين العظم والبون برودكشن أو بيزيد الأوستيوكلاستيك أكتيفيتي واللي هي بتعمل البون ريزوربشن رح يؤدي إلى أوستيوبروسس. وthat's why females بيكونوا معرضين للتو فاكتورز أوف إيجينج أند ذا بوست مينوبوزال ستيج فبالتالي they are more prone for osteoporosis. So regarding the morphology and the appearance of bones that are affected by osteoporosis, the hallmark is loss of bone. So احنا بنخسر من كتلة العظم، نخسر من بروتين العظم، ما بنخسر المينرال كونتنت. المينرال كونتنت اوف ذا بون، يعني عم نحكي عن كالسيوم، فوسفورس، مغنيسيوم، هاي المينرال كونتنت از نورمال، بت وات از افكتد از ذا bone protein. The production of bone by osteoblasts is markedly decreased. And also the osteoclastic activity is increased, but not dramatically increased as the decrease in osteoblastic activity. فأكتر شيء بيميز الاوستيوبوروسيس هي كتلة العظم بتقل. في loss of bone protein, which is mainly due to decreased osteoplastic activity. The mineral content is normal. In scenario osteoporosis اللي بيصير نتيجة الـ aging, الـ cortical bone loss is prominent. Cortical bone loss زي الـ bone of the femoral neck اللي هم الـ weight bearing bones, predisposing these bones to fractures. احنا عم نحكي عن الـ senile osteoporosis. الـ postmenopausal osteoporosis the story is different. Now in postmenopausal osteoporosis, the trabecular bone loss is more severe, not the cortical bone. So in the senile form, cortical bone, femoral neck, more severe. بينما بالpostmenopausal osteoporosis, trabecular bone loss is more severe. Examples on the trabecular bone هو vertebral bodies. This will lead to compression fractures and collapse of these vertebral bodies. ليش بصير فيها fractures؟ لأن الاوستيوبروسيس بيخلي البون عرضه أكتر للفراكتشرز. So if you can see here, this is the normal vertebral body. This is called the trabecular bone, مش cortical bone. زي السبونج شكله. And this is the vertebral body that is affected by osteoporosis. Look at the thickness of the bone. صار في collapse في الvertebrae. صار في decrease في thickness of the vertebrae وزيادة بالفراغات between the bone أو بين السبونج زي ما شبهناها. But this is a bone or a vertebral body affected by osteoporosis and this is a normal vertebra. There is compression fracture and there is decrease in the thickness of these bones. طبعا this bone is more affected in postmenopausal osteoporosis and femoral neck in senile osteoporosis. Regarding the clinical features of osteoporosis, the most important complication or symptom is bone fractures. Mostly vertebral fractures in the postmenopausal osteoporosis like thoracic and lumbar vertebrae. Fracture of these bones or collapse of these bones may lead to decrease in height. The person or the patient may appear to be shorter. And the appearance of some deformities like kyphoscoliosis of the spine. The other fracture that is common is the femoral neck fracture. The problem with osteoporosis is that it is difficult to diagnose and the plain x-rays اللي هي الصور الأشعة العادية it will not detect osteoporosis لحد ما 30 to 40% of the bone mass is lost. So this is late. Other forms of imaging are usually used in diagnosis which are more sensitive. But the most important thing in osteoporosis is the prevention because you can't stop osteoporosis once it starts or once it begins. The prevention is mainly by maximizing the peak bone mass before the age of 30. وهذا يتم عن طريق dietary supplements of calcium and vitamin D to build bone and the regular exercise. The treatment after the diagnosis of osteoporosis is also by vitamin D and calcium supplements in order to stabilize the condition and in addition the use of anti-resorptive drugs which inhibits the osteoclastic activity or the osteoclastic resorption like bisphosphonates and estrogen hormone in addition to the use of some osteoanabolic agents which stimulates the osteoblast to build bone. Now we come to the second disease of the bone, which is rickets and osteomalacia. We always discuss them together because they are both the manifestations of the same cause, which is vitamin D deficiency. However, rickets occurs in vitamin D deficiency in children, and osteomalacia is due to vitamin D deficiency in adults. So there are different names to the same disease according to the age group. Here the bone matrix is unaffected, or the bone protein. Here we have an impairment of mineralization, وبالتالي accumulation of unmineralized matrix, bone matrix. So it's different from osteoporosis where the mineralization is normal and the decrease is in the bone protein and in the bone matrix. بينما هون البون ماتريكس موجودة ولكن في مشكلة في المينراليزيشن، والسبب الرئيسي هو الفيتامين دي ديفيشنسي لأنه هو اللي ضروري لتثبيت الكالسيوم والمينرالز in the bone. So again, rickets is vitamin D deficiency in children in which it interferes with the deposition of bone and bone minerals في the growth plates. And osteomalacia is the adult counterpart in which bone formed during the remodeling is under mineralized, resulting in predisposition to fractures. One of the important manifestations of rickets in children is the bowing of legs, بحيث انه بيصير في زياده في التحدب او زياده في الكيرف of the lower limbs in these kids with rickets. أو اللي بيسموه بالعامية مرض الكساح أو بالعربي. The clinical manifestations of rickets and osteomalacia depends and the skeletal abnormalities depends on the severity and the duration of the deficiency and the age group. In infants, for example, and in kids whose growth plates are still open and the bone is growing, there are many features of the disease like craniotabes. Craniotabes means that the skull bones are softened when you press on them, they are soft. Frontal bossing was squaring of the head. Lumbar lordosis, they are like abnormalities in the curve of the vertebral column, and bowing of the legs. In adults, the contour of bone is not affected, but the bone is weak, وبالتالي it's more vulnerable to fractures. This is what we mean by craniotabes, which is the softening of the skull bones, the occipital bones usually, and the parietal bones. When you press in them, you can feel this softness. And here you can see the difference between the normal lower limbs and the lower limbs with bowing, bowing of the legs, تقوس الأطراف السفلية in a patient with rickets. As you can see here, there is an inward bowing. Here you can see many of the clinical features of rickets. As we said, the bowing of the legs, the craniotabes, the frontal bossing, and like squaring of the head, abnormalities in the chest. We call it pictus carinatum, and many other abnormalities. Let's turn to another disease of the bone, which we call it osteomyelitis. Anything that ends with itis is called inflammation. So osteomyelitis is defined as inflammation and infection of the bone and the bone marrow. It can be secondary to any systemic infection, but more frequently occurs as an isolated, the primary focus of disease in the bone itself. It can be an acute osteomyelitis or chronic osteomyelitis. طبعاً, any organism can cause osteomyelitis, but the most common of which are biogenic bacteria and the mycobacterium tuberculosis that causes TB cell. So we will start with biogenic osteomyelitis, which is also usually an acute osteomyelitis by biogenic bacteria. Routes of infection, كيف توصل البكتيريا to the bone. إما hematogenous dissemination through the blood, which is the most common pathway, أو extension from an adjacent infection, like an infection in the joint or a surrounding soft tissue to the bone, وبالتالي the bacteria gain entry to the bone from an adjacent structure. Or a traumatic implantation of the bacteria to the bone after a fracture or any orthopedic procedure or a trauma. Causes of biogenic osteomyelitis vary according to the age of the patient. Staphylococcus aureus is the most frequent causative organism overall, Staphylococcus aureus. E. coli, Escherichia coli, it is another bacteria, and group B, Streptococci, are important causes of osteomyelitis in neonates. They can also cause septic arthritis in neonates. Salmonella is an important pathogen in patients with sickle cell disease, the same as for septic arthritis, which we talked about in the previous lecture. The clinical features and the symptoms for osteomyelitis is classically it manifests as an acute systemic illness, sudden onset, with malaise, ta'ab aam, irhaq, fever, leukocytosis, elevated white blood cell count, and the throbbing pain over the affected region. Very important, the throbbing pain in osteomyelitis. Symptoms can also be subtle, أحياناً, minimal symptoms with only unexplained fever, particularly in infants, because infants can't explain to you, or sometimes the changes may be subtle. There is no swelling, there is no severe pain, but the infant also only is irritable with high fever. Sometimes when you examine the infants, so you might find a swollen bone or tenderness over the bone. When you try to move the limb of the infant, for example, the infant or the baby starts to cry. And this is one of the features that makes you suspect osteomyelitis fever of unknown origin or unexplained fever. In adult patients, usually there is pain, but sometimes it can be only localized pain without fever, without other symptoms, especially if it is sometimes a chronic osteomyelitis. The treatment for osteomyelitis is a combination of antibiotics with surgical drainage and surgical debridement to remove the pus and the purulent materials that are accumulated at the site of the osteomyelitis. These treatments are usually curative. They can cure the disease, but in about one quarter of cases, they do not resolve and they persist as a chronic infection with chronic osteomyelitis. The complications of acute osteomyelitis in infants. We are afraid always of the spread of infection from the bone to the adjacent joint causing suppurative arthritis because the epiphyseal plates, the growth plates, are open still and not closed. وهذا بيسمح للبكتيريا, it permits the movement of the bacteria from the bone to the joint space. Second is the development of pathologic fractures. Any minor trauma due to this weak bone due to osteomyelitis, inflamed bone is a weak bone, so we can have a fracture to any minor trauma. When the bacteria gains entry to the blood, we may end with sepsis and the infection may be transmitted to the heart valves causing endocarditis. Rarely, a development of squamous cell carcinoma if the infection عمل sinus tract وضل chronic infection for a long period of time ممكن it can be complicated by squamous cell carcinoma of the overlying skin. Rarely, osteosarcoma develops from an acute osteomyelitis because usually osteosarcomas are malignant from the start and very rarely إنها تتحول osteomyelitis إلى osteosarcoma, but rare things could happen.